Welcome to this video. A function module is one of the most important ABAP objects in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. The SAP system uses function modules in numerous places for the proper functioning of the SAP system. A function module encapsulates the ABAP code and thus enables reuse in different places. And because of that, in this video, I would therefore like to explain the term function module in more detail. In addition, I will show you how to create and use a function module easily and quickly. Enjoy this video and let's get started. Before jumping into the SAP system, I would like to explain you what a function module is in general. A function module is a cross-program reusable procedure that is structured in function groups. And here on the right hand side, you're seeing a funnel and you can compare it to a funnel. So you put values into it and get an output. And in the funnel, this data is processed. And a function module encapsulates an ABAP code. And data is transferred via a defined interface consisting of various parameters. So here I am right now in the ABAP editor in the transaction code SE38. And no, function modules are not maintained in the ABAP editor. They are maintained in the function builder in the transaction code SE37. I will show you in a couple of seconds more closely. But in here we're seeing that with the statement call function, I am calling this function module set underscore ERP underscore app. And in this simple report or in this simple function module, I am exporting one purchase order number and I am getting one username, the creator of this purchase order. And in this case, I'm also using a changing parameter and some exceptions. And with the forward navigation, so if I double click on this function module name, I end up in the function builder, so in the transaction code SE37. And in here, we're seeing the logic of this program. So basically, it selects the table echo, so the table that contains information about purchase orders, and exports the creator of this purchase order. So if there is no entry, then an exception is being raised. And then just for demo purposes, the changing value is being changed by the C value that you can put into. So based on ERP up, there is a prefix. So, and now I would like to explain you parameters more closely, because here it is important that in the definition of the function module, there you're using, for example, importing, exporting. And if you call a function module, then you're using the other way around. So we've seen already some examples of parameters. And as explained, data is transferred via a defined interface consisting of various parameters. And the parameters are the interface. And so following parameters or parameter types are available. Import. Import parameters are used to pass values or variables to the function block when the function block is called. Import parameters are passed with the keyword exporting when the function block is called. You export values to the function block. So to speak, the function module imports them. They can be marked as optional so that they do not have to be supplied for the call. Export parameters are always optional. This returns values of the function module to the calling program. Export parameters are received with the keyword importing. The calling program thus imports the value. And as we've seen in the example, there we have the mismatch, because in the function module there you're using importing and exporting. And when you call it, then you're doing the other way around, because based on a funnel, if you call it, then you put data into the funnel, and in the function module, then you get the data, so you import it or you export it. Furthermore, changing parameters are import and export parameters at the same time. They are variables that are passed to the function block, changed in the function block and returned to the calling program. The keyword changing allows changing parameters to be used in the call. And you also have an obsolete parameter type, it's tables, so you should not longer use this keyword table. And last but not least, exceptions occur if an error occurs in the function module, and this is returned to the calling program. This one can react there to the error accordingly. The exceptions keyword can be used to accept the exceptions in the calling program. So as mentioned a couple of seconds ago, here we have a function builder. It's the transaction SE37, and this is the most important transaction codes regarding function modules, because in here you can type in your function module based on the fork key. You can search for existing function modules, you can display those, you can change them if you can, and you can create your own function module. If you want to, in here you can also check, do a syntax check, you can activate it, or you can test and execute the function module on your own. And if we go in here into the function module, so for example with display, so once again I think this is really important, the difference between importing and exporting, because in here we are in the definition of this function module, and here we have to use importing and exporting, and when you call it, then you have to use the other way around, because from the calling report there you are exporting data into this function module, into this funnel, and in the funnel there you import the exported data, and the other way around, when you would like to export data from this funnel, then the calling report is importing the exported data. But normally you don't have to manually type in your importing, your exporting parameters. You can use these different tabs. So for example, if we would like to create a new function module, then it is important, as described, to have a function group. So in this case, I would like to create a new function module. So in this case, just do a copy of the existing one. So just set ERP up to. I have already created this function group. You can create this function group on your own in the ABAP dictionary. I can show you this. So you open up the the object navigator, it's the SE80, and in here you have function groups, and here you can right click and then create, and then you can type in a function group that you want to, and then you save it, and then you have created the function group. I won't do this because I have already created this one, and then here I'm using the already existing one, and I would like to copy it to set ERP up to. So copy it. I have copied it, and now I go into the change, maintain an original language, and here you can change some attributes. So for example, the short text, if you want to, you can also set it up to remote enabled module, not necessary at this moment. And in here you're using import, so importing parameters, and I recommend using a naming convention, so starting with IM. So for example, you can specify a type, so for example, EBAN. And so for exporting, there again, naming convention starting with E, for example, with changing, starting with C, for example, tables are obsolete, and exceptions, no entry, for example. And in the source code, the header is automatically created for you, that you see directly in here, some kind of signature, what is the name of this importing parameter, what is the name of the exporting parameter, changing, and so on, instead of moving to the tabs once again. And here you can create your logic. And after using activate, so in this case, I just want like to activate this, this function module is ready for being used. And then you can call it. And for example, if we're going once again to the set test report, you can use a really nice trick. So for example, if I just would like to call the created one, there you can click on pattern. And then here you on the call function, you can type in your created function module. So set ERP up to, and then hit enter or click on this button. And then your structure is directly put into the ABAP editor and is ready for being used. And the optional parameters are automatically commented out. So there you can directly see what is mandatory, what is optional. And then you can pass the values and work, for example, with the changing or with the exporting parameters. So this is really easy way to call a function module. If you want to, for example, you can also type in this call manually. So use the call function statement. Or if you want to, for this, we are open up this report in the object navigator. So once again, I open up the object navigator and the programs there I have set test. I go into the edit mode because you also can use a function module via drag and drop, because on the left hand side there you can select your function module. So to do this, I'm going to function groups. Then I go to this one, set test. And here you click on this node, on this function module, you drag it to the right side, and then you drop it. And then you have the same effect as if you would use the pattern function. So this is also really useful while working with function modules. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have any questions regarding function modules, put them in the comment sections of this video. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and please subscribe this YouTube channel ERP Up to never miss great upcoming videos in the future. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next video.